cheap.
And the guy, was 3 years old.
Service bed.
Were you at City Hall, or are you at the paper, or taking pictures? Oh, okay, because I was trying to find out who might have been taking pictures here. The last... Who is it?
Alden.
That might have been who I left the message to, because I called to see if I could find a picture, and then they never called me back. But I'll try that again. His name is Alden. Okay. Wonderful. Thank you. I appreciate that. Go. Watch this. You don't trip over either. Thank you.
I'm going to
Hey, Nydia, Tisdale. How are you?
I'm doing very well. Thank you.
Yeah, I'm doing great.
Good. The mayor's up.
And we were all on
you don't have to ask him.
Good to see you.
Thank you. So you're in your color guards?
No, it's just a suit. It's we kind of low key. We just wear these hats and we don't dress up. That's what we got.
That's lovely.
Thank you. Thank you.
So you'll be doing this?
No, I'll just be sitting back here, sitting in the back watching. Good to see you.
Thank you.
Come by sometime. Yeah. Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Sometimes I'm so tempted just to make a face. Like a 3-year-old. And that has sound.
Yes, it's a video camera. It's sound and moving pictures, but yes, I mean.
I don't even see a red light to let you know what the drone is.
I know.
It's down here in the front.
I still can't see it, so.
Do you have a list?
Yes.
Okay. Welcome everyone to October meeting of the Cumming City Council, and ask everyone if they would to turn off the cell phone with me. This time I'd like to recognize the Sons of the American Revolution. They're going to present the colors and lead us in the pledge of flag. So all of you stand, please.
Color code, 10. Color, carry colors. To the front, march.
Color guard, halt. To the base. Order, colors. I'd like allegiance.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Color guard, order, colors. Color guard, post, colors.
Consideration of the agenda for adoption. Is any corrections to the agenda, any amendments, additions? Council, do you have anything to add to the agenda?
That's right.
Your motion agenda be approved. If be approved as presented.
Thank you.
All in favor? Unanimous to Councilman Ralph Curry. Being out, he has a medical issue and he won't be with us tonight. Okay, item three is executive session. Is there a need for executive session?
No, sir.
Okay, item four is consideration for adoption of the regular council meeting September the 17th. I assume every member got a copy of the minutes. If no correction, chair will entertain a motion.
Make a motion.
A motion for John.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor? Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, item five, acknowledgments of proclamations. We have anyone here in item eight, total tropical proclamation? Okay, I'll read the proclamation. I'll ask you to come up if you would. This is a proclamation by the Mayor and City Councilman of Cumming, Georgia, recognizing the grand opening of Cumming Pollo Tropical. Whereas Pollo Tropical began in Miami with its simple recipe for citrus marinated grilled chicken and evolved into a world of tropical flavors as well as authentic made from scratch side dishes. Whereas Pollo Tropical is transforming family dining into a lifestyle where passion is married to freshness and create one-of-a-kind tropical experience. Whereas Pollo Tropical has more than 100 company-owned restaurants in Florida, Georgia, and Tennessee. Whereas Pollo Tropical is bringing its popular taste of the topics of coming to Cumming and also provide new jobs for our local community. Now therefore, be it resolved that the Mayor and City Council of Cumming, Georgia hereby officially recognize the grand opening of Cumming Pollo Tropical this 15th day of October, providing that life's better under the palm. Hereunto set my hand and cause the seal of the City of Cumming, Georgia to be affixed this day, October the 15th. 2013. Would you come forward, please? This proclamation here, and wish you well. You got a beautiful building down there, and I don't know that I'll get to the grand opening. Is that this Saturday?
It's going to be next Friday.
Next Friday. Okay. Well, we may make it then. Anyway, it's a beautiful location. Any of you haven't been down Marketplace in the corner of Walmart? They've got a beautiful building there, so I'm sure they'd like to see it. Thank you very much. Okay, item B, Poppy Day Proclamation. I know we have the ladies here for that. I'll read that. Ask you ladies to come up, please. I'll read this proclamation. Poppy Day Proclamation, whereas America is a land of freedom, preserved and protected willingly and freely by citizen soldiers, whereas millions who have answered the call to arms have died on the field of battle, and whereas a nation at peace must be reminded of Christ's war and the debt owed to those who have died in the war, and whereas the red poppy has been designated as a symbol of sacrifice to lives in all wars, and whereas the American Legion Auxiliary has pledged to remind America annually of its debt through the distribution of the memorial flower, therefore, as mayor of the city of Cumming, Forsyth County, Georgia, do hereby proclaim November the 9th, 2013 as Poppy Day in Cumming, Georgia, and ask that all citizens pay tribute to those who have made the ultimate sacrifice in the name of freedom by wearing the memorial poppy on this day and witness whereof I hereunto set my hand and cause a seal of the city of Cumming, Georgia, 15th day of October, 2013. Will y'all come up, please?
To elevate community awareness and respect for our veterans by educating the public about the poppy's significance and the financial support that is realized by our disabled veterans across the nation as a result of its distribution. And thank you, sir, for, like I said earlier, thank you for your personal contribution each and every year. We thank you for your support and always thank you for your continuous support of our veterans. Thank you.
Ms. Sankler, thank you and all the people who work with your staff for making us aware of this every year. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, item C, National Indian Heritage, American Indian Heritage Month. Do we have anyone here? Okay, great. National Society, National Society Daughters of the American Revolution, American Indians Committee Proclamation by the City of Cumming, National American Indian Heritage Month. Whereas the history and culture of a great nation have significantly influenced by American Indians and indigenous peoples, the contributions of American Indians have enhanced the freedom, prosperity, and greatness of America today. Whereas the customs and traditions are respected and celebrated as part of a rich legacy throughout the United States. Whereas Native American Awareness Week began in 1976 and recognition was expanded by Congress and approved by President George Bush in August 1990, designated the month of November as National American Indian Heritage Month. Whereas in honor of National American Indian Heritage Month, community celebrates as well as numbers of culture, artistic, educational, and historical activities have been planned. Therefore, as mayor of the city of Cumming, by virtue of the authority vested in me, the city of Cumming do hereby proclaim as November the National American Indian Heritage Month in Cumming, Georgia, and urge all citizens to observe this month with appropriate programs, ceremonies, and activities. Witness, I have to set my hand and cause the seal of Cumming, Georgia be affixed this 15th day of October in the year of our Lord, 2013. Would y'all come up, please?
Thank y'all very much.
So,
yes, you have an opportunity to do this, ma'am.
Just to use every chapter of the National Society of Daughters of the American Revolution wants to say thank you so much for helping us to honor our American Indians, especially since Forsyth County has a large contingent, a large section of people who are directly related to the Cherokee Indians. And we love it that every year our own festival here on the fairgrounds has an Indian display. And so we thank you so much for including them and in what we do here in this county. And thank you for honoring us by letting us do this.
Well, thank y'all very much for the work y'all did bringing our attention and wiring us to this. And I'm sure you have a treasure if you want personal donations and this kind of thing. Who, where do they make the donations?
Would you like to do it tonight, or do you want me to give you an email address?
Well, you can leave us an address, or and we, if you're still here after the meeting, we'd like to make it.
We'll do that. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Okay, Veterans Day Proclamation. I understand Alan Greenlee and Ed Ritzel here to accept this. I'll read this proclamation here for Veterans Day Proclamation. Y'all would come to the podium if y'all would, please, and then y'all may want to say a few words and then we'll take a picture. Veterans Day Proclamation, whereas the 11th of November 1918 marked the end of war, to end all wars, and cessation of the most destructive sanctuary and the reaching war in human annals, and the resumption by the people of the United States of peaceful relations with other nations, which we hope may never again be severed. And whereas it is fitting that the recurring anniversary of this day should be commemorated with thanksgiving and prayer and exercises designed and perpetuated peace for goodwill and mutual understanding between nations. And whereas on June the 1st, 1954, Congress declared the Armistice Day should be Veterans Day to honor all who had served in all wars to preserve world peace. And on October 8, 1954, Dwight D. Eisenhower issued the first Veterans Day Proclamation. And whereas to protect the nation they love, their veterans stepped forward when America needed them most. In conflicts around the world, their sacrifice and resolve helped destroy the enemies of freedom and save millions from oppression. In answering history's call with honor, decency, and resolve, our veterans showed the power of liberty and earned the respect and admiration of a grateful nation. Whereas all of American veterans have placed their nation's security before their own lives, creating a debt that we never fully repay. Our veterans represent the best of America, and they deserve the best American to give them. Therefore, as mayor of the city of Cumming, we hereby proclaim November the 11th, 2013 as Veterans Day, and urge all citizens of Cumming, Georgia to recognize the valor and sacrifice of our veterans through ceremonies and prayers, and witness whereof I hereby claim and set my hand this 15th day of October, 2013, and Mayor of the City of Cumming. Would y'all come forward, please?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor and the City Council. That's probably one of the newest organizations for the City of Cumming and Forsyth County. We'd like to thank you for your personal support and the council for their support of our chapter. We look forward to working with you in the future, and this will not be our last foray to you for proclamations or anything else the city needs. So thank you again, sir.
Thank you very much for joining. We appreciate it very much. And I'll take this opportunity to certainly invite everyone at November the 11th at 11 o'clock at the War Memorial Park. Service down there that we have. So thank you.
Okay, thank you.
National Disability Employment Awareness Month. Do we have anybody here for this?
Okay.
National Disability Employment Awareness Month, whereas workplaces welcome talents of all people, including people with disabilities, is a critical part of our efforts to build an inclusive community and strong economy. Whereas, in this spirit, the City of Cumming is recognizing National Disability Employment Awareness Month this October to raise awareness about disability employment issues and celebrate many and varied contributions of people with disabilities. Now therefore, the Mayor of the City of Cumming do hereby proclaim October as National Disability Employment Awareness Month, and so doing, call upon employers, schools, other community organizations in Cumming to observe this month with appropriate programs and activities, and to advance this important message that people with disabilities are equal to the task throughout the year. Hereunto set my hand and cause a seal of the great city of Cumming, Georgia to be affixed this 15th day of October in the year of our Lord, 2013. Would you come up, please? Thank you for bringing it to our attention. It's certainly an important project. Okay, item six, old business being none. Item seven, new business, administration amendment to the intergovernmental agreement with Forsyth County in regard to SPLOST VI Funds. Dan?
Mr. Mayor, members of the council, this is an amendment to the IGA we entered into with Forsyth County that reflects that the city has tendered to the county $5.3 million, and that we would receive back $4 million, which we will use on our city parks and recreation projects. Additional funds have been collected since the date of that transfer, and there was interest that accrued on the money that is added into a total of $799,000, change set forth in the agreement. The purpose of this agreement is to recognize other agreement, I think, implicitly said, now this looks exactly, we're going to send to the county a check for the $799,000, and 2 days later, they're going to give us a check back for that same amount, so that they will use money for the parking facilities that are coming, which is like the original IGA set. We will use the additional funds for our parks and facilities. County has already approved this. Chairman Amos has already signed it. It's before you tonight for your consideration, and I will respectfully request that you approve the same on that as entering money.
This is the agreement to the agreement, right?
Yes, sir.
It's probably already done, but the city will have completed our SPLOST VI projects as it referred to, that we would have a parking deck in the city, and this will complete that process, right?
Yes, sir.
All right, what's the pleasure of the board?
I'll make it.
Have a motion, have a second. Have a second, Quincy, in discussion. All in favor? Unanimous. Okay, item two, Lake Alice Access and Partial Settlement Agreement with the Management Trust.
Mr. Mayor, members of the council, as you know, the city has already taken steps to remediate the issues created by the Lake Alice dam burst that happened in May of this year. We are currently awaiting feedback from the EPD on the plan, and the city has committed to remediate the situation. As part of that, we have drafted a proposed agreement between the Management Trust, which owns the majority of the dam and a portion of the lake bed, and the city, which owns the rest of the lake bed. That agreement is in front of you and basically provides that the city is going to submit the plan, that the trust, which owns part of the property, will grant a temporary construction easement to the city, that upon completion of the plan, the city is going to in a survey of the former lake bed at 75 feet on either side of the top of the bank from any streams that are now in the close the lake bed, and the trust will deed that property to the city after the city's work is complete. And next, it provides that each side's going to bear its own attorney's fees and costs and expert witness fees, and either side raising claims against the other. That's it in a nutshell. Glad to answer any questions. I would respectfully request a motion approving this, subject to any minor clarifications that the mayor or myself as city attorney would need to make. I think those have already been made, but if you give us the latitude, if there's a typo or a word that needs to be moved around, you have the ability to do that. Request authorization for the mayor to sign that with that.
We have already, I think this has already been before us, and by virtue of having to come back, the mayor didn't have authority to do it without the council approval.
That's correct. We had negotiated issues before, but I think we're close to a resolution with the Management Trust, and now we're asking for council authority for the mayor.
So it looks the council's got it drawn up in a two-page agreement here. So if council approval is to authorize the mayor, if any changes are made, as council has said, that may be necessary to authorize the mayor to go ahead and sign off on it. So that's what we're looking for a motion for. Chairman, entertain a motion.
Make a motion.
Have a motion from John Dee. Have a second. Second from Quincy. In discussion. All in favor? I see everybody's hand. Okay. Unanimous. No opposition. Councilman Curry, absent.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Item B, utilities, Ball Ridge Marina, Road Gravity Sewer, Force Main Change Order Number 1. Director of Utilities.
Mr. Slater. Members of the City Council. This is a request for a change order to an existing contract with Strack Incorporated. They are a water and sewer contractor that's currently installing a gravity sewer line for the city. The request that we have for this change order is to remove an existing 8-inch sewer line that begins at Uber Mill Road and terminates at the city's pump station there on Uber Mill Road. To remove the 8-inch sewer line and replace the 16-inch sewer line. And the total cost of the change order is $338.20. And the total of the contract will go from $1,564,608.07 up to $1,691,946.29. Strat Incorporated gave us the quote for the initial work that we're asking for this change order, and that Gerald Black will be able to sign the change order for us.
And by upsizing this line that you talked about and putting in the gravity line, this will enable the property on the east side of 400 between exit 15 and 16 to be sewered, right?
That's correct.
And that's something that wouldn't take place without having this additional work.
That's correct.
All right. A recommendation from Director of Utilities John Hurd for a change order for Strike Construction for $127,338.22. What's the pleasure of the board?
Make the motion to receive.
Have a motion.
Second.
Second. Lee, second. Lewis, any discussion? This money come out of utilities, right? We have money for it.
That's correct.
Motion, second. Any other discussion? All in favor? Signify by raising your hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Mr. Mayor, members of the City Council.
Okay, item C, number one is Fairgrounds Alcoholic Beverage Rules and Regulations to be amended or to be brought before the board for approval.
Mr. Mayor, members of the Council, this is a proposed set of rules and regulations that will allow beer and wine alcohol sales or service at the fairgrounds. That can only be allowed by the City Council passing a set of rules and regulations, not currently allowed under existing regulations. So this is a change. It's basically divided into two sections. The first section talks about alcohol sales, where somebody has a festival or event and then have authorized sales. Pay in that example, wanting to buy a beer or a glass of wine. The second example is really related to private events like a wedding. So if somebody wanted to rent the fairgrounds and hold a wedding, where they wouldn't be charging for alcohol, they would just be serving alcohol at a reception, for instance, after a wedding at that location. That's just an example. So the first set of rules is concerning sales, where the person is consuming the alcohol is paying for it. Second is where the host is in essence paying for the alcohol and is being served to the private guests at that ceremony. I'll be glad to answer any questions. This set of rules and regulations coincides and intermeshes with your alcohol code as it exists right now. So it's complementary in that it's basically a separate set of rules that applies just to fairgrounds.
And this will be fairground for special events.
Special events, yes, sir. And it has to be approved by the City Council.
And to apply for a special event license for the fairground, you got to be a license holder already. Is that correct?
That's correct. Yes, sir.
And that's a city license holder.
That's right. Or you would have to acquire it. One and two.
You have to acquire it before you're eligible to apply for this special event. Any other questions?
Now, this one might not be walking around with county beer or nothing like that, beer and fire.
It will not allow that. It requires a designated area where alcohol will be served. And unless someone is renting the entire fairgrounds, in which case you could walk around the entire fairgrounds, but you would not be permitted off that fairground facility onto a city street. So no, it would not be where you could just walk around during the fair, for example, anywhere in the fair with beer. If that's your question.
For instance, the barbecue cook-off that will be held next month, if somebody comes in and applies for the special events license for that, it's got to be designated the area that it's going to be, and probably in the exhibition hall or somewhere. And you can't leave that area with any alcohol.
You cannot, and it requires that whoever's putting them on sell bracelets or IDs will be checked. You'll be given a bracelet that is a particular color that identifies that you're 21 and authorized to purchase alcohol beverages. And it limits the number of beverages you can purchase during a given day. There's a lot of limitations that contain in these rules and regulations. There's an event that is totally under control.
I think it specifies that limits three drinks per day.
It's four per day. So
four per day.
So if you had an event that went for 10 or 12 hours, the maximum alcohol that could be consumed by any individual would be four over a 10-hour period. If you had it all day long, right?
Okay. Any other questions? Chair, I entertain a motion. I'd recommend that we go ahead and do this because this is going to be additional revenue through that. And it's, I think the additional fee is, what, $700 or $300 per?
Yes, sir. That's true. In addition to the additional fee, there is a percentage of gross revenue that the city will receive off of alcohol sales.
Okay. Have a motion. Have a motion from John D. Have a second. Second. Any discussion? All in favor? Raise your hand. Any opposed?
I don't
know. Okay. Three for, and Councilman Sexton abstain. Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Item 8 under announcements. Cumming Country Fair and Festival Overview, we have Dave Horton. Dave.
Thank you, Mayor. We just got done with another successful fair. We had great weather, second year in a row. And we took last year's record of 141,000, which I thought would probably take a couple years before we could get beyond that. But we blew that away and had 167,616 exceeded our expectations. Great run, great fair. We had very few problems. We were spying things here and there. Shouldn't have when you got that many people. We were real pleased with the turnout. Again, the weather couldn't have been better. Temperature range and so on. Went throughout.
Thank you, Dave. Let me commend you as director of the fair programs for a great job. I hear a lot of great comments on the fair. One of the best ever. The cleanest fair they've ever been to. Most activities, they can come to the fair free on certain days, it didn't cost anything. They could come ride the kids free on certain days, it didn't cost anything. It was a family outing. So, again, I hear a lot of great comments. We thank you for it.
Well, it takes a lot of people to put a big event like that on, so I also want to thank Mayor and Council for all your support. You guys are out there every day. Meeting people and talking with them. Also, not the fairground staff, Gerald, Steve, his staff to help us out. A lot of city employees get involved, a lot of volunteers. Casey Tatum, his staff did a great job of security on his side and the gates. It takes a lot of people to make it happen, and a lot of behind the scenes work, so we appreciate all of them there. We don't get any rest. We've got an event starting up this weekend. And we have the fast pace race. It's a 5K, 10K Easter qualifier on Saturday the 19th. On October 26th, we have a beautiful electronic recycling in the big parking lot on Saturday. And on Sunday the 27th, we have this is a new event, Halloween. It's a Halloween half marathon. We're doing a 12-mile race. They'll also do a 5K also. But, most of them will be dressed in costume for that. And then in November 8th and 9th, coming Steam and Antique Tractor Exposition. And then on November 15th and 16th, National Barbecue Cup. Which looks to be as big or bigger than it's been in the past. And I think the first year they were the third largest Kansas City sanctioned barbecue in the nation. So I thought Dr. Randall today, and he's expecting over 100 professionals to be there, so it looks like it'll be another big one. And then in December, the 13th and 14th, Christmas is coming on some craft festival. And we'll have anything to offer.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Dave.
Thank you.
Okay, under announcements, Alex Folly opens at the Playhouse October the 24th, run through November the 3rd. And under announcements, Georgia Mountain Regional Commission Christmas meeting party is December the 6th at the Diller House, Clayton, 6 o'clock. And any other business to come for this board? Here we adjourn. Got a motion, second, in discussion, all in favor? Unanimous. Thank you very much.